Assalamu alaikum. I am Dr. Abu Bakr Siddiq from Rhythm Medicine. Welcome you all to another lecture on Pedigree. In this lecture, we will see how quickly we can identify a pattern of inheritance or pedigree that may be very helpful for exam purpose. At first, we will see the rules how we can identify, and then we will practice with some examples. So let's start. The pedigree, we know that the square indicates male and the circle indicates female. If any square or circle is colored, it will indicate diseased, and if it is not colored, they may be unaffected or carrier. So for identification of the pedigree, we will ask some question. At first, we will determine whether it is recessive or dominant. Then we will determine whether it is autosomal or X-linked or sex-linked. So first question we have to solve whether there is any skipping of generation. Skipping means if any affected person have both unaffected parents. For example, this person is affected, but his both mother and father are unaffected. This is called skipping of generation. The skipping of generation go in favor of recessive disease. In this pedigree, we can see every affected person have at least one affected parent. For example, this affected person have affected mother. This affected person has affected mother. These affected persons have affected father. And this affected person have affected mother. So there is no skipping of generation. All generations are affected. So if there is no skipping, we will call it dominant disease. So in next step, we will identify whether it is sex-linked or X-linked or autosomal. So to decide whether it is X-linked or autosomal, we will see any sex biasness. Sex biasness may have several features. For example, any particular sex is more affected. For example, only males are affected and there is no male-to-male transmission. It will go in favor of X-linked disease. For example, in this pedigree, this affected person, this affected person, this affected person, all are male. So this is X-linked disease. We can interchangeably use sex-linked or X-linked because practically there is no Y-linked disease. So sex-linked means X-linked. So this is a X-linked disease. And from first rule, we can identify there is skipping of generation. This affected person have both parents unaffected. So this is a X-linked recessive disease. In this pedigree, we can see there is no skipping of generation. So this is dominant disease. As there is no skipping, this is dominant disease. But there is no male-to-male transmission. So we cannot tell it autosomal dominant. And we'll see any sex biasness. Here both male and female are affected. By this rule, we cannot identify. We will see some other rules like crisscross transmission. Crisscross transmission means female to male transmission or male to female transmission. That is father to daughter and mother to son. Here we can see this affected father has all daughters affected, but there is no male to male transmission. And this male cannot transmit the disease to his sons. This male, so there is no male to male transmission, and there is crisscross transmission, that is father to daughter. Because if as the father is affected, he has one defective X chromosome, if we write it XD, and another is Y chromosome. So all of the daughter will get the defective X chromosome, so they will carry the disease. So as this pedigree is dominant, that is no skipping of generation, and there is a sex biasness, we can identify the crisscross transmission. This is X-linked dominant. And in this pedigree, we can see there is no skipping of generation. All generations are affected, and both male and female are affected. So this is not X-linked. and there is male to male transmission, male to male transmission. So this is autosomal. So what we have seen, for sex biasness there may be particular sex more affected. If there is only males are affected, we can tell this is sex biased. If there is crisscross transmission, that is father to daughter, all daughters of the father are affected, it will be also X-linked. And if there is male to male transmission, it will be autosomal. Sometimes some pedigree do not follow the above rules. There are some special rules that only female transmit the disease. We can get some pedigree, only female transmit the disease. This affected female is transmitting the disease to his sons and daughters, sons and daughters. But once the male is affected, he cannot transmit the disease to his son or daughter. But once the female is affected, she can transmit the disease to his sons and daughters. This only maternally inherited disease is called mitochondrial inheritance. So at first look, we can make mistake by making diagnosis of a dominant disease. For example, all affected person has affected parents and there is no skipping of generation, and male female both are affected. We can make a mistake by doing diagnosis of autosomal dominant. Actually this is mitochondrial inheritance, because all the inheritance pattern come from mother, maternally inherited disease. Here if we summarize, first step, whether there is any skipping of generation. If there is no skip, it is dominant. If it is dominant, then we can ask whether there is male to male transmission. If there is male to male transmission, it will be autosomal dominant. And if there is no male to male transmission and all daughters of the affected man are affected, that is crisscross transmission, it will be X-linked disease. And if there is no skip of generation, it will be recessive disease. And if only males are affected and no male to male transmission, it will be X-linked recessive. And if both males or females are affected, that is non-sex biased, and male to male transmission, it will be autosomal recessive. So we can tell the male to male transmission is an important feature of autosomal disease, especially autosomal dominant disease. And if there is no male to male transmission, we can suspect it is X-linked disease. And if there is a special rule like only mother transmit the disease, we will call it mitochondrial disease. Here we will see some example. There are 15 example. We can practice how quickly we can identify for exam purpose. At first step, we should identify whether it is dominant or recessive. Then we will identify it is autosomal or sex linked. Here we can see this affected person has affected mother, this affected person have affected mother, this person has affected father, and this affected person has affected mother. So there is no skipping of generation, so we can tell this is dominant disease. And next thing, whether it is sex linked or autosomal, for this we have to see whether male and female both are affected and any male to male transmission. Here you can see male and female both are affected and there is male to male transmission. So it is autosomal dominant disease. Here we can see there is no skip of generation. All affected person have at least one affected parents. So it is dominant disease. Is there any sex biasness? As both male and females are affected, so we can assume it may be autosomal disease. But there is another particular pattern of sex biasness, that is father has transmitted the disease to all of his daughters, all daughters are affected, and this father have transmitted the disease to his only one daughter. So there is crisscross transmission, it is a feature of X-linked disease. So this is a X-linked dominant disease. Here we can see there is skipping of generation, so it is recessive. And next thing, there is sex baseness, only males are affected. So this is X-linked recessive. Here we will see also skipping of generation. So this is recessive, but here both male and female are affected. So this is likely autosomal recessive. Here we can see all affected person has affected parents. This person has affected parent. There is no skipping of generation. This is dominant. And as male and female both are affected and there is male to male transmission, it is autosomal dominant. Here we can see there is a special pattern, that is only maternally inherited disease. This mother is transmitting the disease to his daughter's son, but once the man is affected, son is affected, he cannot transmit the disease to his sons or daughters. But once the mother is affected, she can transmit the disease to both his daughters and sons. So this is mitochondrial inheritance. So we can make mistake by doing it as autosomal dominant because there is no skipping of generation, all generations are affected, and there is both male and females are affected. But for autosomal dominant disease, there must be a male to male transmission. Here is no male to male transmission. We can tell it mitochondrial inheritance. Here you can see there is skipping of generation. So this is recessive disease and both male and female are affected. So this may be autosomal recessive, and there is male to male transmission. It confirms it is autosomal recessive, and there is no other pattern like father transmitting the disease to all of his daughters, etc. In this example, you can see there is no skipping of generation. This is dominant disease, and there is male to male transmission. If there is dominant and male to male transmission, we can tell it as autosomal dominant. And both males and females are affected. Here we can see there is skipping of generation. So this is recessive. And then look for sex biasness, as both male and females are affected. This is not X-linked recessive. So this is likely autosomal recessive that can be confirmed by male to male transmission. This is male to male and male to male transmission, autosomal recessive. Here we can see any skipping. There is no skipping of generation. This is dominant disease. And is it X-linked or autosomal? So we can ask whether male to male transmission. We can see there is no male to male transmission. There is no male to male transmission. So it cannot be autosomal dominant. So is it X-linked dominant? So for this we can look for sex biasness. We can see that affected father has all daughters affected. This man has two daughters, they are affected. This man has three daughters, all are affected. So this is X-linked dominant. Here you can see there is any skipping. No, there is no skipping of generation, so it is dominant. And whether it is autosomal or X-linked, is there any male to male transmission? Yes, there is male to male transmission. We can tell it autosomal dominant disease. Here you can see there is skipping of generation, so it is recessive. And next thing, both male and female are affected, and there is male to male transmission. So this is autosomal recessive. Here you can see the there is no skip of generation, all generations are affected. This is dominant, and we can see sex biasness by crisscross pattern. There is, this man has three daughters, all are affected. This man has one daughter, all are affected. So this is X-linked dominant. In this example, we can see that the disease is only maternally inherited. This mother is transmitting the disease to his sons, daughters. But once the son is affected, he cannot transmit the disease. Next generation is healthy. This man affected also cannot transmit the disease. But once the female is affected, she is transmitting the disease to her next generation, both sons and daughters. This is mitochondrial inheritance. In this example, whether there is any skipping of generation. Yes, there is skipping of generation. We can tell it recessive. And any sex biasness? Any male to male transmission? Yes, here is male to male transmission, and both male and females are affected. So this is autosomal recessive. So this is some, these are some examples by which we can identify the pedigree very quickly. I hope you enjoyed the video, and it will be very helpful for exam purpose. Thank you.